Don't stop looking in my eyes.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hello, my name is Sarah Palmyra and I love chatting about skincare, makeup, and all things beauty. You guys, it has been a journey making this Get Ready With Me video. I tried a new self-tanner, okay? I tried the Tanologist Tanning Face and Body Drops. These are supposed to be really easy to use. You're just supposed to pop like one or two in your moisturizer and it gives you a gradual glow. You can do up to 10 drops. I used 4 and my results were horrific. Basically, it looked like I had a 5 o'clock shadow because all of the tan deposited towards the middle of my face, including my mustache and like chin area, and it created this beard looking appearance, and it was tough. I filmed anyway, and it was kind of funny, showed you how I can do a quick glowy look, covered up the tanner, and then I realized that my sound cut out and I had no sound for the entire video. So here we are for a third time. So feel free to grab a drink of choice and join me in this easy, quick, get ready with me look, and let's get into it. Hello, you are all zoomed into the face. You guys know the drill. Let's get some product on the face. First things first, I'm gonna go in with a sunscreen. This is the Fenty Skin Ultra Hydra Vizor Moisturizer, and I've been testing it out, and I so far like it. This is the texture. It looks like a regular moisturizer. What I like about this sunscreen is it's super glowy. It kind of reminds me of just a glow-based primer. And of course, being designed and created by a woman of color, there is no white cast whatsoever. So you can rest assured that it's not gonna wear funny under makeup. One of the cons, however, is that it is scented. Now, I don't like to demonize fragrance, but I do have sensitive skin, so I have to be careful. I also just don't like smelling overly fragrant products when I'm applying them to my skin. Smells kind of like bubble gum. I can't really put my finger on it, but it reminds me of like a drugstore moisturizer from Olay, like that kind of smell. It's like a powdery floral scent, but overall, it does dissipate in time, which is helpful. And I really like it because it doesn't sting my eye area. So you'll notice that I add the sunscreen all up in my eye area because that area is so delicate, it needs to be protected from the sun. And some sunscreens don't do well with that and they'll get into my eyes and sting them, but this has not done me wrong so far. Also really enjoy the packaging. So stay tuned for a full review on Fenty Skin. That's gonna be coming your way soon. I've been trying out all of the products for about a week and I will update you on all of my thoughts. That's given us a really nice glowy finish, but as you guys know, I can't stop just there. So I'm gonna go in with my Beauty Blur by Vita Liberata. You guys may have seen this in a Zoom Get Ready With Me. I will link that video right here. But I really love this because it's just, it gives my skin such an effortless, beautiful glow. It's really lightweight though, and it's very pore blurring. And the goal with these products is not to give your skin necessarily a tan, but rather just give it a little bit of warmth. Kind of what I wanted these drops to do, but permanently, you know, something that wasn't a wash-off product, but it just went so badly. So if you guys have any self-tanners that you recommend for the face, let me know. I love Saint Tropez for the body, but I haven't found a face tanner that I like. And being that I always use sunscreen on my face, I kind of always have a face that's lighter than my body. So I would love to just, you know, take a peek into that self-tanning world. But as you can see, this really amps up my glow and it just does something. It illuminates my skin, it wakes up the face. And I find that as opposed to a lot of other illuminators or highlighters, I'm thinking of the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Flawless Filter. This doesn't feel heavy. Whereas I felt like the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter did feel sticky and heavy on my skin. I think this is great for a lot of different skin types. I also sometimes like it mixing it in with my foundation to give it a little bit of luminescence. But right here, we're gonna use it as a primer. And then I'm gonna kind of spot conceal with my foundation. So for my foundation, I'm gonna go in with the Make Up Forever Reboot Foundation. Another really amazing one that I've talked about in the past that I just kind of, you know, fell off. I actually stopped wearing makeup for a while as well. But this is the Reboot Foundation. I really like it as well. Super natural finish. And I love the undertone of the colors. Makeup Forever does olive skin tones really, really well, just like Giorgio Armani does. And I like that this has a really nice skin-like finish. It's not matte, it's not dewy, it just is. And then I'm gonna go in with a kind of dirty, but very well-loved complexion sponge. This is the Real Techniques sponge. Oh my God, I can't believe I've been sleeping on this product for this long. It is so, so good. I prefer it to the Beauty Blender because it has this flat edge that really allows me to kind of get in to the nooks and crannies and just kind of press everything into the skin very evenly. And I just like it better. It's softer and I think it blends things out way better than the Beauty Blender. I feel like Beauty Blenders are kind of weird. I don't know if you guys agree, but depending on which individual Beauty Blender I get, I'll prefer some to others. And it just depends on the one I get. It doesn't matter about the color. It just, some of them are better than others. These are amazing. You can get like a pack of four on Amazon. And I love that it has this flat edge. I use mostly the flat edge and then I can spin it around and kind of pat everything in with the rounded edge. But as you can see, skin's looking fresh, awake. That's what we want. And then for concealer, I'm gonna show you guys a newer concealer. This is the Clove and Hallow concealer. I love it. Shade 3. Peachy undertone, which is kind of key for the under eye area. What I love about this is, first of all, if you're looking for a clean concealer that's more affordable, Clove and Hallow is where it's at. But this is the creamiest, most blendable, lightweight concealer. It's really nice. Now, it's very different than the e.l.f. concealer, which I've been raving about. The e.l.f. concealer is a bit thicker in consistency. It's more of a heavy duty concealer. This is the perfect everyday concealer. Never creases, super skin-like finish. Again, it's not too dewy, it's not too wet, it's not too sticky, but it's not matte. It does allow for drying time, so I can talk to you and not worry about this area setting before I blend it out, which is really key. And the color is perfect for my skin. It's like a perfect peach where it's not too peach, but it really cancels out those blue and dark areas, so I really, really like that. This provides a medium coverage as well, and as you can see, it's just illuminated the face, super spreadable formula, and I've been using it so often. I didn't mean to keep it from you guys, but I haven't filmed in a while. I am going to be repurchasing this. It is fabulous. All right, you guys are seeing a lot of old favorites that I haven't picked up in a while and a lot of new ones. This is Arrives Beauty Bronzer and their brush. Okay, this brush is so heavenly. It's so soft. It kind of reminds me of Charlotte Tilbury's brushes. I don't know if you guys have ever played with them, but they are on another level of softness, but they're extremely expensive. This has a really expensive feeling handle. It's heavy and the bristles are just so soft. They're perfectly domed, which really helps when it comes to bronzing up the face and kind of contouring the face, but I use it for every powder product just because it's so soft. I really hope they come out with more. And their bronzer is a clean bronzer, it's talc-free, and mine is in the shade Light Medium. I really love it because it's a perfect undertone where it kind of sits in between a bronzer and a contour. Not too warm, not too cool. I just really love it. Also has a little bit of a sheen to it, but nothing crazy. And I adore it. It's just been such a nice discovery of 2020. And with the brush, it's kind of a perfect combination. And I don't like to be careful, which is why I like products that aren't crazy pigmented, because they kind of allow me to be a little messy. I kind of take it back towards the ear and underneath the chin. And as you can see, that's really warmed up the face. I'm gonna go in with a fluffy brush as I always do and tap it into that product and just take it across the eye. I always do this because my eyelids are a little oily, but ever since I started doing it, I just feel like it really ties everything together and my face just looks really seamless and polished and uniform. So I really like doing this, just popping a little bit of that bronzer right in the eye crease. Next up for blush, I'm actually gonna go in with this palette by Kaleido Cosmetics. This is the Skinluminate palette. This is a new palette to me by a new clean beauty brand. Here you have two shimmers and one matte, and you have the shades Coral, and these two are peachy shades. So far so good, very new palette, but I really like it because their mica is ethically sourced and they're vegan and cruelty free. So I'm gonna tap in with that matte shade first, the Coral one, right over here. And just very gently dusting that towards the middle of the cheek up. Very finely milled powders here. I really like the feel of these. Next, going in with a very stained, larger, fluffy brush, I'm gonna go in with this middle shade here. It's nice because it's kind of like a shimmery blush, but it's going to act like a highlight for me today. I'm just going to take it on this brush and just add it to the tops of the cheeks. It's going to give a really beautiful glow. I really like it. It's very, again, finely milled. It's not going to cling on to pores or emphasize any texture, but I really like it because it was meant to be a blush. It kind of has that shimmer without, I guess, looking like a stripe or anything like that. For my brows, you already know it's gonna be Benefit Gimme Brow. This is really old and battered at this point. I've just been using it up. I really like how fluffy it makes my brows, and it just does something without doing too much, if that makes sense. Now for mascara, you already know I'm gonna go in with my Shiseido Lash Curlers. I feel like I've never explained to you guys why I like these over maybe a drugstore. The reason I like them so much is because these really stay firm. So when you use an eyelash curler for a long time, it kind of loses its firmness, which is what creates the lift in the first place. So then you end up having to change it out every year. This is 2 years old and it's going so strong. I don't feel like it's losing the firmness. And you can just buy the new little rubber pads that it goes in, which are way more affordable than like buying a new lash curler every year. But it's been the most long-lasting one I've had. So, I don't know. Now I'm convinced that maybe a more expensive lash curler is worth it. Next, I'm going in with the MInk Kush Mascara. Now, the reason I love this mascara is because my lashes stay really, really soft and it's easy to remove. So a lot of mascaras get really crunchy and crispy and I hate that feeling and they kind of flake off. This never does that to me, so I really, really like it. But it is a wetter, thicker formula, so it actually, I think it gets better once it dries out a little bit. Okay, last but not least for lips, I have two products from Revlon. These have been new discoveries and I am obsessed with them. So this is their lip liner in the shade MInk. I absolutely love it because it's just so soft. I'm gonna show you how I use it. I kind of take it on the bottom to really emphasize that area. And then I very lightly overline my lips. It's a very nice pinky nude. For the top of my lip, I actually like to kind of overline that a little. And then lastly, I like to draw little lines like this, here and here and here and here, because when I add the lipstick on top, it's a little bit sheer, so you kind of see those lines and it makes my lips look a little fuller. Next, I'm gonna go in with their lipstick. This is the Super Lustrous Lipstick. It's very, very creamy. It feels like a lip balm, and this is in the shade 020 Nude Illuminator. It looks like I'm wearing a gloss, but it doesn't feel oily. It feels like I'm wearing a lip balm. And I just think my lips look so juicy and it just really ties the whole look together. Now, last but not least, you can powder. This one by Patrick Starr is so gorgeous. First of all, universal. It comes in a translucent shade and then a few other shades. I picked up the shade translucent and it really helps blur pores without creating too much dryness, which is what I look for in a powder. I really, really like it. It's my favorite loose powder that I've discovered so far. I'm really picky when it comes to powders because I have dry skin and I love a dewy look and I don't want to compromise on that. So I take some into this little lid that they have here, swirl my brush aggressively into it until I don't see it onto the brush, and then I just pat in the areas where I feel like I want my pores minimized, which is usually just the T-zone. And you guys, that is the finished look. Promise you it only takes 5 to 6 minutes if you're not talking to the camera, but I hope that this was really helpful. Let's do a zoom in to see how everything is wearing right now.
All right, so everything is looking pretty good. As you can see, I have that skin-like glowy finish and my pores are blurred and minimized and the lips are looking super juicy with that Revlon combo as well.
All right, you guys, that is the finished makeup look. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, I think that this really takes 5 to 6 minutes if you're not talking to your camera, and it really just helps me feel more awake, more polished, more excited to take on the tasks of the day. And so if makeup can do that for me right now, even if I'm indoors, I'm going to do it. Loving this lip combo. Please comment below any video ideas / requests that you have. I really do take note and I have a few coming up. Fenty Skin, a full review of Coco Kind, COSAR X, and I'm gonna be doing a video series on my favorite products of 2020. We're gonna talk about cleansers, moisturizers, essences, treatments, makeup. So really, Stay tuned, keep those notifications on, subscribe if you haven't already. And yeah, I'm just really excited about all the content that I filmed. Comment down below, what's the one makeup must-have that has been keeping you sane during 2020? Oh, and self-tanner recommendations, if you have them, for my poor face. See you in my next one, you guys, and wishing you an amazing week as always. Bye.